So, welcome all dear friends. It's 1700 hours IST, it's 5 p.m. here. This is a part of Integrative Bioinformatics workshop that we are going to have, you know, several sessions. But, you know, this session is something, you know, very interesting, something, you know, close to, you know, the students, and especially the fourth wing of BioClues, which is entrepreneurship. We work on four main principles: mentoring, outreach, research, and entrepreneurship. Vishwanathan Dupatla has got a dual distinction of being a mentoring chair, but he himself is a kind of an entrepreneur. He has an illustrious career of 2 decades, a chemist by training and a PhD from IISc. And a prestigious research background, you know, working for Marie Curie fellowships, and as well as, you know, working for US. He always has had a penchant, you know, to return back to India and serve his motherland. That was how, you know, Visu came close to IKP Knowledge Park. IKP Knowledge Park is based in Genome Valley, and he has been promoted to assistant vice president of IKP Knowledge Park, which is based in Genome Valley, Hyderabad. He also has a wonderful, unique, I would say, blend of not only working towards causes, social causes, but he also has a wonderful, you know, mentoring experience working or helping, you know, incubatees or budding incubatees, you know, in his company. Bring, you know, some kind of, you know, collaborative spirit, not really the competitive spirit, but bring the collaborations or bringing, you know, the collaborative convergence towards these, you know, budding incubatees based in IKP Knowledge Park. So far, he has successfully mentored several companies, and he really wanted to help a lot of, you know, students from his point of view. So please, you know, utilize this opportunity in going through his wonderful presentation today. After this, you know, we also have another entrepreneur in making, Mohan Kumar Mega, whom I'll introduce later. So Visu, thank you so much, you know, for your time. The floor is yours, please.
Thank you, Press, and good evening to all of you. So today I just wanted to share a very simple story, how a student from a normal background can make use of various fields and look for better opportunities. So I took my case study as an example. Since today there are so many students from the bioinformatics background, I thought I will present my story from my learning from the bioinformatics side. So please feel free to ask anything. Just a disclosure, I am not a bioinformatician. As Prash introduced, I am a biochemist, but I will be happy to speak on how I could make use of those things. And as you can see, the title, it's about joy of learning science and how we can make use of various opportunities available. The reason for joy here, not only here, anywhere. Some of you might be very familiar with this diagram. So this is from a very classical Japanese associated one. I will not go into explaining this thing, but whenever you are doing something, so there is a need for money, being students or employees, for everyone. So it is a need. So if you are doing something that you love and that pays you money and that is required by the world, and if you are good at it, I think, you know, your career choice by default should be in that field, be it bioinformatics, be it biochemistry. It should be very clear to you that this is how you are going to process. Then you don't have to think so many times. So many a times there will be so much confusion about, you know, what kind of career I want. I'm not very clear whether I want to be a programming person, if I want to be a manager. So once you know that, you know, this is what you will enjoy, you can plan accordingly, and I will just bring this at a later stage. I come from a very small village where English is not even a medium, where until high school I never learned about ABCD. Yet only after joining in Navodaya school I started learning. Thanks to all my friends, seniors, teachers who helped me. I frankly want to say that there is nothing like you can't learn or you can't do. There are always people in this, in your journey, they will be happy to help. You just have to ask them for your problem to, you know, to be associated. They will be happy to help you. So thanks to all of them. I will not go into the science part here in detail, but a small disclosure, the following science is about the science companies was present, made by a company called Cytal, Science Talent Company. The company teaches science students using live examples. I have worked with them for 2 years in certain universities in Andhra and Karnataka. So the following few slides were made during that time. And the company is also associated with another company called C-Drive, which helps in recruitment of CEOs, CTOs, CSOs. It's a Bangalore-based company. Again, thanks to my friends, I was able to interact with their company and work with them. So as you know that every year there are so many science, before very less students were coming and there are several opportunities, but everybody nowadays says that there are so many students coming out every time and there are so limited opportunities. So how you can think about your journey in a smooth way, I mean your career. So during this time, there are limited job opportunities, there are unlimited students, but are the companies very happy with the students what they have? So we went and spoke with you know, several companies. Most of them are in the biology field, pharma, biology, biotechnology, industrial biology, industrial biotechnology. So 50% of the employees are very unhappy actually with the students whom they are getting, and 25 are okay. 25 said it's okay, they can manage. And ironically, 78% of the, most of these companies get the toppers, right? Because the initial recruitment is based on mocks and how good you speak English. There are very limited things that bachelor's and master's students will be selected based on a elaborate interview. It's a very short interview and only persons who can speak very nice English will be selected. And it turns out that 78% of them need at least 4 months to just to understand a simple workflow for a master's student. Though they are the toppers, they need 4 months time to accommodate. And in some cases, they need more than 6 months. So the reason for telling this is what you need to focus when you are studying, when maybe your experiments, live case studies. And so we went back to the students, their CVs and the feedback. The companies actually took some of the very nice people and they don't have any problem with explaining basics. They're very good, but when it comes to the problems, most of them, at least 55% have issues. Sorry, 45% have issues and they were unable to deal with them. And when a new thing is given, there are even more number of people who have problems. And to communicate their problem or how they are working, half of the people from these best schools and schools have problems. So the reason for presenting what the companies are having problem is when you are going as a candidate next time, or maybe in 2 years, 5 years, maybe after your PhD, you should think about you know, what are the skills they would be looking and what people have problems. So just to summarize, mocks are not everything. And you need to start thinking what you need for the ikigai. So what you are good, what will be paid for, and what is needed for the world. So start thinking from now. And with this, though I said like there are limited opportunities, I tried to look for various opportunities available for the master's students. Very generic one. This is the slides will be shared by press, so you don't have to take photos. So these are the various opportunities available. Before it was always, during my time, it is MSc, PhD, regular teaching job. We don't have awareness, but now thanks to internet and senior support, you can read about most of these things. If you pick a review from a decent journal, which will have the job notification from most of these things, quality control, regulatory affairs, clinical research, supply chain management, business development, intellectual property, market research, and all these are equally important. It's when we are, you know, in the lab working, we always think that only working in the lab is the most important thing, which is important, but there are equally important career opportunities available. And if the bright students go there, they really do well. I just looked at some of the companies in India, and of course globally also present various fields like pharma, biopharma, contract research organization, diagnostics, intellectual property rights related. There are unlimited opportunities available. If you're always looking that you want to work in the lab, there is a problem. But the minute you are open, that is where what you love, what gets you money, if you are very clear, all these opportunities, unlimited opportunities. I studied intellectual property rights during my MSc, but I never thought that is a career option because I never had any senior or somebody to tell. But now I work at IKP Knowledge Park, where I know there is a technology transfer office, and these people are really valued and they are very much essential. They are essential for making scientists to need make money and to protect their intellectual property. These are very important people. I always studied only for getting marks or getting pass in their subject. So I'm just sharing all these opportunities or various fields so that you don't just focus on becoming only scientist. I'm not discouraging that, you should become, but there are several opportunities. There will be a very soon the call opening for the master students who are completing. This program is called SPARSH from the Department of Biotechnology, and various fields are there open: maternal child health, aging, food and nutrition, waste to wealth, and food products, preventing wastage. So in this program, they pay 50,000 rupees per month, Indian rupees, and for 18 months. During this fellowship, they will also give you 5 lakh rupees. And they will also, IKP and similarly other SPARSH centers, they will take you to the places where the problems exist. So you can immerse in that environment and understand what is the problem and come with a solution. And I'll be very happy to talk to anybody who may be interested. As I said, that opportunities are there. So I thought I will just present during the COVID time. This is from IKP Knowledge Park. So we have a new fund, it's called ICO Fund, IKP COVID Fund, where I will just minimize the screen photo so that, yeah. So where 2.5 crores initially was sponsored for various companies, for 15 companies, and they were able to raise 54 crore rupees. And not only that, during this process, they were able to help more than 85 lakh people, be it diagnostics, PPEs, ventilators, hand sanitizers, masks, thermal screening systems. So the reason for sharing this slide is we are always working on a science, and you know, we love to do path-breaking science, but at the same time, if you like to solve the problems of the society, you should be able to think that this is the area I want to work and this is where I'm going to make an impact. So before coming to this job, I never knew actually that a scientist can contribute to any of these companies. But I realized that most of us can work for most of these companies and play a very important role. So as I discussed in the WhatsApp group, I will be happy to take one student. Presh or the organizers can suggest a student from anywhere who will be interested in taking a different career choice, or even the regular research career, because I felt that we are not, as a scientist, we always work about lab-related work and you don't focus much about promoting ourselves. So most of the time I see the scientists are undersold, like, you know, we don't know our value, which is good in a way because we don't worry so much. I'm not saying anything bad about MBAs and other people, but I really like this about science students. They really enjoy doing that. But at the same time, we should not be on the losing side. So I will wait for the organizers to suggest a name and I will be happy to work with you. To start, various steps in my career. The first thing is I wanted to start with my MSc project. There is a reason for telling this, because the program what I'm handling, Biotechnology Ignition Grant, is for supporting master's student. And during master's time, there is, I'm sure, you know, most of the institutes will have something called a master's project, 3 months, 6 months, one semester. And many of us, at least during our master's, want to go to very nice institutes or very hi-fi places, or, you know, want to work on some very hi-fi names, what we were not understanding that time, actually. But for me, the choice was very simple. I wanted to work in a place where I'm comfortable and I don't spend a lot of money. In Calicut University, the room rent was only 15 rupees per month. So I stayed back there. And I also know the research lab where in our department, where they used to work on a very nice model organism called Physarum polyciferum. So there will be a million nucleus within 1 to 2 minute difference of mitosis phase at the same time. It's a beautiful yellow organism. And I really liked it. And we can do very simple experiments using very simple cell culture UV microscope. So, and I'm very happy that I was able to publish that 4 months work. So never worry about going to a big place or doing something very hi-fi. You can do very simple things and still get benefit out of it. In this case, I'm talking about publication. I'm sure most of you will be aiming, but just to tell you that you should decide about the place depending which will benefit you, rather than going to a very big place which may not benefit you and you have to struggle. In 6 months, 1-2 months will go in just settling in the city. Just think about all the possibilities and choose what is best for you. Just following on with my master's project, I took one case study from a master's student in the agriculture, horticulture, whom we have mentored for the biotechnology ignition grant. In this grant, the students are the researchers, are the innovators, entrepreneurs are given 50 lakh rupees if their idea is chosen for the funding. So what they have done during their masters, so they were isolating various fractions of the fruit, various fractionation methods. And one fraction, when it is kept near the window, there are several insects coming towards that, various flies. They were like, you know, so why this fraction? That time there are no advanced things to do any experiments, because these are just master student, right? Like when some researcher will be given, and they will not have so many resources at disposal. So when they have taken this fraction and kept on a filter paper and just kept in different fields. So what they have noticed is, if you keep, for example, if you take from a mango and keep it in a mango orchard, there will be a lot of insects. But if you go and keep in a cucumber field, there are very less insects. Similarly, if you take an extract from cucumber and take the particular fraction and keep it there, there will be several insects. So that's, you know, they have later on characterized, because in the grant application, they would ask, what is the problem you are solving? What is the technology? What is the chemical you have identified? So during the process, this is all before the grant application, just based on their MSc work. So this they have just done in their village. No hi-fi lab, very simple. So they were able to identify a fraction which kept when isolated from the extract of the vegetables, put on a filter paper and hang there. It will attract all the insects and there will be no more insects. So these chemicals are called chiromones. They work like sensors for the insects to go to the food. So here they are trapped. So they got this idea and they tested, and they were able to prove that these are very specific. These do not remove the normal pollinators. Only the certain kind of insects are which are attracted towards the complete grown food. In this case, not the flower. Flower is not affected, but only the either cucumber or the final fruit or the vegetable is the one is the source that is attracting the insects. And once they got this one, they made this into a, they took a dustbin and various boxes where they put that extract dried. And within next day, they are able to see several insects within the box. Huge amount, actually. So they got so many insects that they got idea that that insects can be sold. And again, so he again, this is where IKP Prime I was mentioning. This is the technology transfer office where they have helped several students from ICER and various institutes, central universities, IITs. tomorrow there is a talk at 3:30. It's about simple how to protect your innovations nationally at the Indian level or the global level. So please feel free to register. I will post a link where my presentation is there, and there is a poster as well present in the same folder. So that is the stage where I met them. They are from a small village in Karnataka. So when I went for promotion meetings, I met those teams, and then I brought them to IKP Prime, and they were able to guide that if you can present your innovation, not just like this works or something, which is true, like this is very good, but when you are presenting to a committee, you should be able to present properly. So if it is an intellectual property, what are your claims and how you are going to make money, how you are going to develop. So all the detailed plans, and our team will be very happy to help students. Last 2 years, we have been working with ICER Tirupati, IGEM. I'm sure most of you would be familiar about IGEM competition. And they went into the gold level thanks to the support of the IKP Prime team. And any of your institutes, universities are going, we'll be very happy to help. Please write to the organizers or ask your teachers to write. My email ID will be there in the presentation beginning and ending. And once they have perfected that idea, during the project time, they were able to go to the fields and demonstrate, not just on one field, on multiple fields, multiple vegetables and fruits. It really works. They are still in the process of launching a commercial one. But imagine a small farmer getting 50,000 rupees extra in a 3-month time. So it's almost like 2 lakh rupees per 1 year. You know, what is the difference here? Before, these people used to use a lot of insecticides, which made these cucumbers and all the vegetables disqualified for promotion export purpose. So they can't export once the pesticides are there. Maybe for local consumption, unfortunately, they are allowed, which should not be, because be it export or in Indian consumption, it should be the same. But unfortunately, as per the guidelines, they cannot export if there is pesticide, but they can sell in the local market. But once they were able to use these kind of traps without using the pesticides, the value of the vegetables or fruits they are growing has increased almost 3 to 4-fold. Of course, they were selling only for 30% more, but in the market, the price has increased by 3 to 4-fold. Can you imagine the impact it is going to create? So the reason for presenting this is, during their MSc, they have done a small project, but they were able to go to an organization like IKP Prime, take their help. And there are, I'm sure, in most countries and most institutes, universities, there will be faculty members who are willing to help, be it IKP Prime, be it your institute. So please go and discuss. Again, this comes to Ikigai. So where you love doing something, where you get paid and you enjoy and the world needs. So please reach out to somebody who can guide you. And if you have some confusion, please speak to your teachers, and I will be very happy to talk to you. Please excuse me, my WhatsApp is making a lot of sound, and I will just close that and then... And then about my experience at the Indian Institute of Science, I was very fortunate to be a part of this organization where I learned a lot, more than by doing experiments, just by listening to my friends and seniors, I learned a lot at this institute. A very good thing about the institute, my professor D.N. Rao was there, very open. So when I went there, they told we work on DNA binding proteins, the methylation proteins, DNA cutting enzymes, so you can choose what you like. That time, somehow I liked DNA mismatch repair. During master's time, we will have certain preferences, maybe because of our limited knowledge or a colorful review we read or the images. At least my time, I don't have exposure. I read very few journals, so I don't know much about science, frankly. I was very fortunate to go there. So I choose DNA mismatch repair, and I choose to work on Haemophilus influenza and Neisseria gonorrhea because of a phenomenon called phase variation, where the bacteria, once their antigens are recognized by the host defense system, they switch off those antigens and start producing new antigens. So for me, it was very fascinating how bacteria are so clever. And later I realized that they are really clever and they can evade so many of these things. And if you are looking at the corona, you know that even the virus is even more clever. Coming back to the DNA mismatch repair. So when there is a DNA replication is going on, there is a daughter strand and parent strand. And when there is a mismatch, there is a structural distortion in the DNA. The distortion is recognized by specific enzymes, mutase. And an enzyme unwinds it and cuts it, and exonuclease remove the DNA near the mismatch, and the gap is filled and sealed. So this is a standard mechanism. But in the Neisseria gonorrhoeae and Haemophilus influenza, this enzyme which nicks, the mute H, hemimethylation nicking enzyme, is not present. But how the DNA repair happens is not clear. So that is when I started. So there were like 11 proteins involved. In classical biochemistry, you will, that time cloning characterization is a very, you know, fashionable, I would say. So soon after master's, I thought like I started reading and then realized that it will take so much time and I have only 5-6 years to do the entire research. So that is where the bioinformatics, we had a molecular biophysics and there is a biophysics unit. And there is a bioinformatics laboratory with all hi-fi computers and in the super SCRC supercomputer center where I took the course. Very basics. I had very limited knowledge only. I know what is blast, what is alignment. Very simple things, but I have never done. Then I took all these things and I struggled and downloaded some sequence. That time, you know, you can't print whatever you want. In those times, everything is counted in the lab. Which is good, actually. I think, you know, I feel that we should be accountable for the things we are using. So when I looked at all these proteins and alignments, with, of course, with the help of those people, there are two you know, groups of enzymes came. The enzyme is called mutel, the linker and the activation enzyme. Many of these nicking enzymes need to be under control. They should not cut the DNA anytime. They should only cut when there is a mismatch or activated by another protein. And the mutel is a protein which activates the nicking activity by 1000-fold at least when there is a mismatch. As you can see in all these organisms in the group B, there is a motif DMHAE. There is a acidic residue stretch that is present, which is not present in the E. coli, which has a nicking endonuclease. So obviously we know that there is some difference, and similarly in the humans also, there is no mutate enzyme present, but the DNA mismatch repair is happening. And that is the time when there was a cell paper just after we have cloned this one, saying that this is the enzyme that does the job. I have just cloned and seeing my gels. That is the time this paper came, and we were little sad and very happy that without a very complex work, we are able to identify the enzyme which is involved. So in the science, it's not about that you do everything, but it is your collaborator, friends, you all work with them, and scientists everywhere. You should be very happy. Many a times I see my friends very disappointed when something is published by so-called competitors or others. But I feel that we should be very happy that they are sharing their data with us in such a refined form. Of course, you know, as classical biochemistry, the first thing we have done is to clone, purify, characterize. We found it is a dimer. It binds to the DNA. I will not go into the details as I mentioned, but we were able to show that this particular enzyme has a very high affinity for the DNA. When there are mismatches, it binds very strongly. And as I mentioned, that the C-terminal domain is the one that has a DNA binding activity. So all these steps took almost like 2.5 years. And that is the time, same time when we have seen a paper where a famous lab published saying that the mutel activity, mutel of humans and yeast has DNA binding and nicking activity. So it's a very simple assay. You incubate this purified enzyme in presence of a metal ion. And that's the way you show that this metal ion is able to nick the DNA. So the reason for telling this is, without knowing hardcore bioinformatics, I was able to go to people who are working on bioinformatics and explain that this is my problem. And you know, that time taking in a floppy drive, all those things, and opening and explaining to them with notes. I was able to convince them that it's a very important thing, whatever I'm seeing, and they are able to help me. And since some of you are doing advanced programming, and I'm seeing in the group discussions, so you can really help so many people who need your help, because by helping them, you are increasing the impact of your work. And I'm sure you form very nice collaborative groups. And just for the sake of time, I would skip about my other part on interleukin 4. Again, I had faced the interleukin 4 in a Marie Curie project, where I had to prepare interleukin 4 at 1/10 of the cost available in the market, which I was able to do for a few companies. In the same way, again, I faced with another bioinformatic support issue, because a lot of structural biology was involved. So again, I went to the structural biology people to tell that this is the protein I'm working. I want to modify a residue that will not impact the interleukin-4 binding. So they were able to come up with various regions. I made 24 mutants, and four mutants, as they predicted, exactly didn't disrupt the interface of interleukin-4 binding, but they can block the receptor activation. So the point of showing these things is, if you know what is the problem you are addressing, it is not the complexity of the problem, but it is the problem per se, what you are solving is more important. So always focus about what you are trying to solve. So after my postdoc, as Prash mentioned, we wanted to come back to India. So again, coming back to India, I didn't come back to a science lab. I came back to a management place in the 2016 November. I felt actually, I was looking forward to coming back to India because from what I had seen long back in 2000s and after IASC, where I was doing my research, I had seen a lot of improvements. Like, you know, bachelor's and master's students are able to do practicals, they're able to present papers, they're able to access internet. So I felt that there was a lot of improvement. But when I came back, I felt that the students are complaining that they don't have anything, but they actually had no clue 20 years before how it was. But I was very lucky to have some students who worked with me and helped me in establishing a lab at MNR Foundation. It's a medical college and dental college with a few colleagues' support. And as always, friends, network always helps you. Always reach out to your seniors, talk to them, explain to them. There is no shame in saying that you don't understand or you don't know something. They'll be always happy to help. So after 2 years from at MNR, Foundation for Research and Innovation, I came back to IKP Knowledge Park. So 3 years before coming back to India, I went and met the CEO of the IKP Knowledge Park for doing an internship. So actually everybody in the room laughed that after doing PhD in India and all the fellowships, you want to do an internship. I said, yes, like for a scientist to start a company, whatever they claim that time, IKP Knowledge Park, I was never aware of things that this can be done actually, that I don't know that government will fund if a student has an idea and you can create an impact. So I really felt that I can create an impact because I know the pain. So when I had seen that enzyme which can cut, so I, in the lab, I was always telling my boss, we should patent this thing and, you know, we will get money and we can do help other people, which is true. But in the science, it's always about focused project, what you are doing too, and not much about intellectual property. It's not about making money, but it's about enjoying science. I think there should be a balance. You should enjoy science, but at the same time, when there is a possibility of improving the science per se by gaining some money to the lab, I think one should always do it. So just an example, a screenshot from IKP where to show that impact it can generate. So with a 100 crore support from IKP, these scientists, innovators, more than 700 small startups, BSc students, MSc students, PhD students, postdocs, faculty members, they're able to generate 2,500 crores of money. So almost like, you know, 25 times the money what was given to them using their science by taking those product to the market. In the process, they were able to file several IPs and create an important asset for the company. and 7,500 jobs were created in the process. So you can imagine the impact these science students who went into the entrepreneurship have created. I'm not saying that everybody who went there was successful. There were struggles, there were difficulties, but there are some examples where these students were able to establish their own organizations. I'm just showing the Indian map. I know there are some participants from other countries. We'll be very happy to have a chat with you as well. And I'm advising few students from other countries for the projects like iGEM. I'll be very happy to talk with your colleagues, your teachers. If you are going for a competition, I will request some support from our IKP Prime team, who will be very happy to extend that time. We have various incubators. The idea of showing this is, we, although we are present in Bangalore and Hyderabad, we'll be very happy to help anybody anywhere. So you just have to ask. And these are the some of the facilities when a scientist want to use, of course, for a charge. But we'll be happy to discuss about things, what you will need. So now I would like to start presenting about few examples where I felt actually first time when I had seen that it is a simple thing, like will it be viable? So I had doubts, but looking at the person presenting and, you know, their enthusiasm to convince others, I felt I learned from them and I supported them, and ultimately they got the funding support, maybe 50 lakhs, maybe 100 lakhs. So this is by a woman called Sauzanya. She is a BSc or BCom student. She had heard from, you know, various people that using the same shaving brush in the barber shop causes spread of some diseases, which now most of us are familiar how the diseases can spread by using these kind of things. You can imagine that a wet brush used for a one person, because in the barber shops most of the time it will be the same thing, and the barber cannot throw those things. Just 1 minute. I think lot of what is the first thing very dispensable to. Okay, so I will come back to the Q&A session later, and we will stop like maybe 10-15 minutes before, and I will start interacting with. So they have chosen banana, the plant, because after the banana is harvested, the plants are cut and they have to be discarded. In their village, they were able to harvest those stems, dry them, and process and extract the fiber from them and make a self-foaming, like, you know, you can take directly and dip in water and start using. So for 5 rupees, they were able to make a disposable shaving brush. Can you imagine the 5-star hotels, how much they will like this, you know, this kind of thing. And at the same time, preventing the spread of diseases in public barber shops. Even in the, you know, if you go to a very nice saloon, most likely they will be using the same brush. Maybe they will dip in water twice. Not that it will create any impact, but it will just, we feel it is good, but still it will have the same organisms. So this team has been very well recognized, and Tirumal Tirupati Devasthanam and several places have given them an opportunity. And in Vijayawada, Nellore, several shops have started using these things, because it's only a 3 rupees extra expense which they will charge to the customer. But imagine during COVID time, if you are in case if you are going to barber shop, which I don't suggest, and you know that everything being a disposable thing and it is a biodegradable thing. So this is a very simple problem they have seen. They started working, they went to several labs, and you know, they went to Central University. And I really like that they are from a non-science background, but they were able to convince the very senior scientists and professors that, okay, we want to know how many microorganisms will be there at the end of this process. So there is a scientific process involved in these product creations. Though it looks like they took the banana stem and made a disposable shaving brush, but they have followed all the things what we will do in a lab or I will do to, for a validation. And I can't emphasize the importance of supporting the healthcare system during these times. And this team is from IIT Bombay, very nice engineers. They have worked with, you know, Formula One, and they have designed a cricket bat, which will have a differential stroke rate. I really love this team. But coming back to the product, so this is a simple sheet which can be put under the mattress. And by keeping that, you can measure the respiration rate, heartbeat. And now they have a extra a BP monitor, SpO2 sensor. So I actually use it even in my home, like when the patients are the people who are infected with COVID just came home for the initial thing. So these people are able to convert so many simple, just normal beds into a step-down ICU. It means you can monitor all these parameters and the nurse even need not go there. There will be a dashboard with 50 patient names. And only the patients who need the help, whose respiration is not good or whose SpO2 levels are low. So the nurse has to go to only that particular person. Otherwise, they have to go every 2 hours. And you know, for the nurse to go to 20, 25 people during these times, the healthcare staff are very less. So you can imagine the impact they were able to create. I think around 25,000 plus beds were created using this method. And all these hospitals without needing so many extra nurses, they were able to monitor these COVID wards. And most importantly, the doctor's time was very well utilized. The doctor can come out of this 250 bed hospital, they can just look at those 5 critical patients first and send them to the next level or attend them or ask the, you know, required house, the doctor to see. So they have a war room kind of setup in Nagpur, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Rajasthan, several places. So it's a very simple one. In 2017, they were thinking this about, you know, the kids who are staying abroad wanted to know about the health and, you know, how my parents are sleeping, if they are going to get a heart attack, what to do. So this was initiated, you know, with a such a, to address such thing. But during COVID time, this was extremely useful. And now they have a medical grade. And I'm very happy to share that they won all the awards and they have enough money to employ more than 100 people in such a short time and provide. So but you can't create an ICU because the amount of money required for creating these things, you know about the kind of equipment costs, like it may cost a few crore rupees for these complex looking things. But they were able to simplify in a sheet all these 5 parameters just coming on your mobile phone or a screen. Again, so I am sure most of you might have heard about CT scan, CORAD score, X-rays during these times for family members. And if you are going to a normal hospital, maybe if you take the CT scan or X-ray evening or maybe next day sometime, you have to wait for the radiology report because there were very few radiologists available. But the team Predible is able to make a, this is again bright engineers with informatics background. They were able to employ the machine learning for the images and very quickly identify. So if there are like 500 images, they can tell the doctor, these are the 5 images, you have to look at it. So they are like 100 times more faster, I would say. It's not directly that they would give the reports. I would request, instead of typing, you can stop me and then I'll be happy to explain. Or my time is up. Okay.
Yeah, you can take 5 more minutes.
Another 5 minutes. I just close. So this is one of my favorite the biotechnology ignition. So all these are biotechnology ignition grant projects where the students received a 50 lakh support. And of course, maybe they raised 5 crores, 10 crores, 15 crores, or in some cases, 50 crore rupees. I will not go into those specifics, but I just love these students who have a passion. Again, what they love, what, again, I go back always to the first slide. Dr. Vishal Ravi is a surgeon and when he did surgery for the voice box in case of certain cancers, severe case, stage of cancers, those patients won't be able to speak. And the surgery would cost anywhere from 70,000 rupees to 1 lakh or more, depending on the hospital where you are going. And for a normal person, it's a very expensive thing, spending 1 lakh rupees, and there is no guarantee that it will work. Even they are imported voice boxes, but there is no guarantee. So that is when, he was very much worried that, his patients are coming and he's doing the surgery. They are spending so much time and there is no guarantee. And then it's a very simple thing. Voice box, if you love physics, you know that it is a simple resonant. Simple resonance is the one that produces sound. So he was able to sit and inspire a toy maker to make that resonating voice box, and they can do it for less than 100 rupees. Actually, this came in BBC and many channels, 1 lakh to $1. So more than 150 surgeries were done for almost no cost. And until now, all of them are perfectly fine. The problem of, that warranty issue is not at all there even for this $1 device. And the government has supported, and they are working out of a FDA compliant kind of facility almost. And I wish they will be there everywhere. And they have received requests from almost all countries to establish. I'm sure in most of these countries, there will be support systems available from the government for the ideas or the projects. They are at various stages. This is mainly from the Indian context, the DBT created an organization called BIRAC to support students, researchers who are working on the translational projects. I'll be very happy to discuss about this on a separate one, or you can Google my name or YouTube. There will be several videos on biotechnology ignition grants. Yes, thanks to all of you, and I will be very happy to discuss.
Excellent talk. Before we go to the Q&A session, a big round of applause, please, for Visu for his scintillating talk. You may just unmute your microphone and have a thumping applause. Yeah, thank you so much.
I can hear them.
So friends, we have almost 20 minutes. So please, feel free to interact. It's a kind of a golden opportunity for everyone, to interact with Visu. He has really taken a busy time out of his schedule. So please feel free to ask whatever questions that you have in lieu of entrepreneurship and job prospects. Yeah, thank you so much. You may just unmute your microphone or raise your hand. Yeah, thank you.
Hello, sir. Good evening.
Yes, please go ahead.
Yes, sir. It was such an inspiring talk, sir. So actually, I wanted to know this thing, before going up for any startups, what can be the most indispensable thing that that for all of us, scientists at the beginner's level, they might need, sir?
Okay, for the reference of everyone, I posted a small URL where there is a folder, how all these projects are reviewed. So the first thing is, are you going to solve an unmet need? So if you are going to solve an unmet need, there is a problem, but there are no solutions. So there will be, you have to go like a flowchart. Next, are you the only person, or there are 100 people who would be able to solve that problem? If you are able to solve the problem in a unique manner and others cannot solve, can you patent your intellectual property? Can you establish a business model? Can you produce it for a reasonable cost, commercially viable? There are customers who will be willing to buy. So there will be a long flowchart will be there, and I would request you to have a small look. And the first thing always, are you going to work on a problem that is not solved? So please Google, use PubMed, start looking at the literature. First, make sure that there are no solutions. Sometimes it happens that there are few solutions available, but for various reasons, they did not take it forward.
Thank you, sir.
Actually, there will be a sheet where it says that how they are going to evaluate. So if you just go to bit.ly visu ikpbaz, I think there will be one folder which says that how the evaluation of projects are done in the translation and biotechnology ignition grant. It will give a fair idea to most people. And I feel that not only for the biotechnology ignition grant, for most competitions, this will be applicable. So if you score well on those 5-6 parameters for your reference, I'm sure that that will be a very interesting product what you're going to make.
Okay. So, like I had the doubt, like if for thinking of startup, sir. So from where do this?
I can't hear clearly. Can you speak little loud?
Hello, sir. Is it audible now properly?
Yes.
Okay, sir. So, sir, for this startup, sir, from where we can put the investment for bringing up?
So there are several opportunities available for the students. EUA programs are there, which give a specific scholarship, and the government is giving a specific encouragement in terms of like monetary support or the consumable support in various programs which we have conducted for across India. Students were given 50,000 rupees, 1 lakh to just to make an initial prototype or a product or a test version. It may not be fully functional. I will be very happy to organize a separate session for all those who are interested. Our technology transfer office was helping some of the students who have such interests.
Yes, sir, that will be really nice, sir.
Again, I would request you to coordinate with the BioClues team, and we will have a separate session through entrepreneurship. Thank you.
So, any more questions, please?
Yeah. If I can ask a very simple question, yeah.
Yeah, please, sir.
Yeah. See, this the sequence which you said, no, as the protein sequences we're talking about, no, that which is having a function as molecular markers, no, yeah. I forgot the name, yeah. MLTP, no, MLTQ.
DMHAE
or
those acidic residue stretch you are talking, sir?
Yeah, that enzyme which
that enzyme is called mutates, sir, in the normal.
Yes, yeah,
the mutates.
So,
and
those you said, no, they have this thing, motive, and all are all the sequences, protein sequences have this motives, or can you identify all of them by using motive finding? Yeah.
Okay. I will just share my screen for the benefit of others. So all the organisms that have an enzyme called mutage.
Yeah.
Do not have this motif, sir. The aspartic and glutamic acid residue stretch conserved one is present only in organisms where the mutage enzyme is not there. The mutage is the enzyme that hemimethylation nicking endonuclease. As you can see, Neisseria gonorrhoeae and other organisms, including humans, the acidic residue stretch is very conserved. But whereas in E. coli and Haemophilus influenza, they are not there because there is no nicking activity present in the mutal in these organisms. MLH1, it is called in the human, sir.
So in those organisms, this doesn't have any function?
It has a function. It activates the nicking activity by 1000-fold. So it is present as two different enzymes.
Okay. No, in the organisms. Okay, all right, okay.
So it activates the nicking activity by 1000-fold, sir.
Right.
In presence of a mismatch.
Okay, thank you.
So that's, in fact, sir, that's the basis for the Nobel Prize winning award by Moldrick et al. In 2019.
Okay.
On DNA mismatch repair. I mean, this is, in fact, this forms a very basis in humans as well.
Yes.
And my PhD was also on DNA mismatch repair on hypothetical proteins. When I finished in 2008. The beauty with this is, sir, if we really see across all the humans, in fact, some of the eukaryotes as well. The nicking endonuclease forms the basis. There are some signature sequences across the length and breadth of eukaryotes and eutherians.
Yeah.
And interestingly, just because this DNA mismatch repair activity is absent in mitochondria, there are some proteins that come from outside the mitochondria. They come to the rescue of mitochondrial DNA mismatch repair. That is what we call it as piggybacking mechanism.
Okay.
So you posed a very wonderful question, sir. In fact, that forms a very important scenario in terms of identifying the signature sequences. There could be a lot of aspects with respect to machine learning that could be done these days as well.
That was the main reason I was asking that question. I was okay.
Thank you, sir.
One question to Prashant. Yeah. One question to Prashant. Could you identify some hypothetical proteins having this function?
Yes, sir. In fact, we did. In fact, what we discovered as a part of our PhD was, we discovered a couple of hypothetical proteins that are targeted to mitochondria, because mitochondria harbors only 32 proteins. And many of these particular proteins are sitting outside the mitochondria and does some mitochondria-like function. So we discovered a lot of hypothetical proteins. And unfortunately, since this DNA mismatch repair system is taken from bacteria to the humans, not all of these particular enzymes, like the endonuclease, the nicking endonuclease, and all these DNA, MLH1, MLH2, and MSH1, MSH2, they are highly conserved. So that's one of the reasons why we are not able to bring that rapid machine learning approach, taking these hypothetical proteins as a benchmark. Okay. So we tried it, sir, but not fully, actually.
Okay, let us have some further conversation on that. Okay, thanks a lot, Dr. Vishwurya.
Thank you, Vishwurya, for wonderfully explaining that particular part. Yeah.
And Prash, I have last 5 minutes, so since students are not asking, I just will make use of this time. As I mentioned that I have kept all these, how to make presentations is one of the things which I want most of the students to know, because it's very important you make your own presentations. And many a times I see that students always copy something from the internet and start using it. I strongly discourage such things. You should make your own presentations.
Vishnu, can I ask you something?
Yes, please.
The one you showed how we can attract the insects and put it into a box or something, right? So how do we implement it in a home garden level or a bigger garden level?
So that is presently around 500 to 600 rupees, and they got a government grant from Karnataka government as well. And I think they are the best innovation in terms of sustainable agriculture in Dubai. So now they are maybe in 3 to 4 months they will be available commercially. And you can, the problem for using at a home is like you will have so many different varieties, and that is actually crop specific. For example, you can use for cucurbitaceae family, but in the house if you are having ridge gourd and cucumber and lemon and a mango, it will be very difficult. You have to use multiple things, but they are presently more suited for the fields.
Okay, because I'm talking in the, for not for India, I'm talking for Singapore. So how we can do it here, or is it feasible to get things done here? Because we get a small land to do some gardening, but people used to sell a lot of insects come and spoil everything. So I was wondering, we can suggest something to them, or how it is possible to get it implemented, or...
Actually, Bhutan government has approached this team, and they are in talks, and I will be happy to connect them with you, sir, and they will be very happy. And these are the top three teams from India to go to Brazil to help them make pesticide-free vegetables for export and other things. So I will be very happy to. The team name is called Natura Crop, and the student name is Manoj. I will connect, sir.
And yeah, sure. We will talk it privately on that. Yeah.
And this is the first time I'm talking. Yeah. And Art of Making an Impactful Presentation by Dr. Hema and Dr. Bindu is there. And there is an IP strategy, How to Make, by the IKP Prime. And various things are available that will help you. So please visit this one and make use of thing. And always make your own thing. Please don't copy. Many a times we feel that copying a very good thing is a good thing, but it is the worst thing that can happen to you. Even if something is average, and if you make on your own, this will give you much more happiness and you know, your own. That actually, that feeling is, for me, I think, you know, very important. So I would strongly encourage you to make your own things. Even when you are writing things, please don't copy anything. It's always your intellectual property, whether you patent or copyright, that is all secondary. you are answerable to yourself. So please make your own things. Yeah, please go ahead.
Sir, I have a question. Actually, I'm feeling that we always search literature and then found a problem for research, basic research. Then we will do that. But there is lot of new topics which the researcher are finding the problem, but they are doing only the lab work. Up to industry, that is not going. So what's the problem? Always we discuss about the gap between the academics and the industry.
Yes. So I understood, because I am also from similar background. I came from the academics and working with industry now. That is, there are some specific things, something called prior art search, where the technology transfer offices or the patent attorneys can look into the databases and see how the industry people are, or what are the patents or the prior arts available. And for all the scientists or the researchers who are coming from the academic background, we do it for a very nominal price, or even IKP pays for their prior art thing, what they want to do. So I will be very happy to introduce through BioClues. So you can send a mail. I will work with you. Yes, and today there is actually, I would request Harshada and Apurva, if they are in the talk, to just switch on their videos, so everybody can look at your face and maybe send you an email, talk to you. Hi, Harshada. Maybe you can just unmute yourself. She is based out of Calcutta, and she works for the IKP Prime. And Apurva works for the Biotechnology Ignition Grant. We all will be very happy. So in the chat box, maybe we can give the mail ID. But I would request you to come through a BioClues. I think, Prash, that will be better. And I am done with the time. Thank you very much.
Wonderful. Thank you. Thank you so much, Visu. I mean, for your wonderful time and energy. Friends, you know, Visu is absolutely a great listener and a wonderful helper as well. So please feel free to follow him through Twitter, Facebook, and also email him. He's absolutely a wonderful person. And he's always with us as a mentoring co-chair. So we get to hear from him, you know, very frequently in the future as well. So I would just request all of you to unmute your microphone and give a final round of thumping applause to these subjects. Thank you so much.
So, thank you very much.
Thank you, Sir. So friends, we have the next speaker for today. 1 minute.